I'm Dan Gray for Autobytel. That is a solar canopy, and this is the 2016 Chevy Volt. The Volt has been completely redone for 2016, and it's chock full of great stuff. I think this is one of the coolest cars on the road today. What do you say we go for a ride, and I'll show you why.
The 2016 Volt is offered in two levels of trim, LT and Premier. We tested the Premier model in a stunning incandescent pearl tri-coat with a jet black and brandy interior.
The 2016 Volt improves over its predecessor in a number of ways. It's quieter, it's faster, it's more roomy in the back seat. The styling is completely revised inside and out. There's an integrated 4G LTE hotspot, and if you're an Apple aficionado, you'll love to know that it has Apple CarPlay.
When you plug your iPhone into the USB port, you'll gain voice access to Siri, text messages, Apple Maps, and a growing list of third-party apps, including Spotify and iHeartRadio.
The Chevy Volt is an extended-range electric car. It is not a hybrid. Electric power flows to the two motors, which then power the wheels. When the battery runs out of juice, it kicks on the generator, or the range extender, as General Motors refers to it. It's a 1.5-liter four-cylinder engine that runs on regular fuel. And that'll give you all the range you need. You never have to worry about running out of electricity when you've got a generator on board.
The 2016 Volt has a battery range of approximately 53 miles, raising the bar 15 miles over the 2015 model. The total range has risen from 380 miles to 420. Our open road testing showed the battery range claimed to be quite accurate. The Volt can be fully recharged through 120 volt outlets with a charger cord in 13 hours, or in 4.5 hours with a 240 volt charging system. High speed level 3 charging is not supported. There's significantly more zip off the line. Chevy's official spec pegs the 0 to 30 time as 2.6 seconds and the 0 to 60 time as 8.4. The Volt's new two-motor system delivers better acceleration between 0 and 30. Chevy claims a 90% improvement through increased power and decreased weight. Battery capacity is up as well, and the new 18.4 kilowatt hour battery pack is 20 pounds or so lighter than the previous version. There are four drive modes: normal, mountain, sport, and hold. I spent much of my week driving in hold mode to see how fuel efficient the Volt is while running on gasoline. My numbers were in the same ballpark as the official EPA highway estimate of 42 miles per gallon. The new 1.5-liter range extender runs on regular gasoline rather than the previous generation's required premium fuel. This will save Volt owners a significant amount of money when filling up the gas tank.
The leather-wrapped steering wheel is nicely padded and offers a host of controls. On the left-hand side, you've got cruise control, your heated steering wheel, your lane keep, faves down below, and on the right side, you've got Bluetooth, and controls over the information display in the center of the dash.
The dashboard display provides a wealth of information flanked by battery level on the left and fuel level on the right. The display is configurable with classic and modern designs. The new Regen on Command paddle on back of the left side of the steering wheel allows skilled drivers to pump more electricity back into the battery. A rear view camera is standard. Available safety technology includes rear cross traffic alert, blind spot mirrors, lane keep assist, low speed front automatic braking, and IntelliBeam headlights. The Bose audio system features 8 speakers with a subwoofer. A 12 volt outlet and dual USB ports are located at the base of the dash. There's a second 12 volt outlet for backseat passengers. The center stack controls benefit from a return to conventional design. The rear seat provides 35.8 inches of headroom, 34.7 inches of legroom, and 53.2 inches of shoulder room.
Ooh, that's kind of low. And it is still snug in back of the Volt for sure. I've got maybe only a finger or two of headroom, and really at 5'10", right here, I've got the window and the trim. It's pretty tight. Comfortable, upright, snug. If you're smaller, no problem. If you're bigger than 5'10", it might be a problem. Nice big squishy center armrest, two cup holders, literature pockets in the back of both seats, and there's a nice cutout so your knees fit. I've got just enough leg room. My feet are tucked underneath the seat, and the front seat is back to where I'm comfortable driving. Big plus, one level heated seats. Dig that a lot. The biggest difference here in the back seat between this new 2016 and the previous models is this place right here. You could fit a small person there. You could fit a third person. There's belts, right? There's room, but they've got to be pretty skinny to fit. And they do have to straddle the cup holder, so that's a bit odd. Really, it's three across for a very small third person in a pinch. LED reading lamps up top. That's a nice touch.
The trunk allows for 10.6 cubic feet of storage behind the rear seats. Folding down a 60-40 split rear seat provides plenty of room for larger items. The 120-volt charger is stored in a compartment on the left side of the cargo area, and a tire inflator is supplied in lieu of a spare. The 2016 Volt is considerably improved over its predecessor, with a more responsive drivetrain, more range, a refined, quiet ride, and a splendid interior packed with technology. While the previous generation Volt did not sell as well as the company had hoped, surveys show that Volt owners are among the most satisfied in the industry, and that a whopping 70% of Volt owners have never owned a GM vehicle before. So is the new Volt really worth the price tag? Well, you'd do well to ask someone that owns the previous model to see if they're ready to trade up to the latest version.